So my name is Mark Doswell, and I'm one of the producers of Soundmind. It's a neurofeedback audiovisual installation. The inspiration was me being interested in the effects of music on the brain and how it affects individuals differently, and how we could kind of portray that in an art installation, basically.
I'm Rory Pickering. My role is basically electronics, figuring out some of the power requirements and wiring inside the dome, and also programming how the visuals actually get to the LEDs themselves.
My name's Jim, and my main role has been coming up with a structure which would allow us to express what we need to do with the lights.
I began by playing around with different biosensors. I first of all was hooking up plants to a biosensor. It was kind of essentially like a simple lie detector, and then creating music from the plants, just random MIDI notes. And then I wanted to see what it'd be like using brainwaves, so the electrical impulses from the human brain. But it was too random, so I wanted to take it further and project it into a lighting display instead. It's an audiovisual neurofeedback installation. The neurofeedback aspect refers to being able to receive a signal back from the data of your brainwaves. So they're being processed in real time, that's then automating the lights.
Trying to represent what's happening in someone's brain when they're listening to music, so it's their emotional responses and it's levels of excitement or anxiety or concentration. There's different markers that you can use to indicate someone's state of mind when you read their brain waves, and what we're trying to do is kind of use those markers to actually affect the visuals that you see in the installation.
There's a lot of work involved. The assembly of the dome, you know, there's like 46 rings that needed to be laser cut, and 950 LEDs to be placed in the holes. And yeah, there's quite a lot of work, but no, it's been really fun, and yeah, it's been a great experience putting it together.
One of the biggest challenges that I found was actually mapping the dome. So when you move a shape across the surface of the dome, how do you actually deal with that in a 2D sense? So everything we're sending is basically a rectangular video, but we're mapping it onto a sphere. So it's just working out how to warp the visuals so it will actually work on a three-dimensional shape.
I think these are exciting times where the possibility of listening to your brain waves and starting to understand what's going on in the mind are possible, and I think this brings that to people's attention.
We've talked before about turning it into more of an outdoor installation, so maybe it's for festivals or kind of arts events, light festivals, that kind of thing. Obviously we can go further with the actual structure as well, so at the moment it's built out of laser cut ply. We've kind of got a technique for building bigger structures out of just repeating shapes, and I think there's a lot more we can explore with that.